Good afternoon, everyone. Today, I will be presenting this paper, and the topic will be control surfaces. The control surfaces will be regarding the aircraft. The aircraft, first of all, I would like to thank KIT College for providing this platform to introduce this particular edition. So, in the first slide, we see that aircraft control systems are of different types, like primary, secondary, and auxiliary, or we can say it as a tertiary also. So, next slide, please. So in the aircraft, this is the leading edge and that is the trailing. So here you can see that there are flaps, there are ailerons, there are elevators, there are rudders. So these all are control surfaces. And the main control surfaces are like ailerons and rudders. Like the rudder will be like the vertical stabilizer, and the elevator will be the horizontal stabilizer. And the ailerons, the main aim of ailerons, like for example, this is the aircraft. So if we want to move the direction of the aircraft, so one should be down and one should be up. Then only it can rotate like this. And the same way, if we want to roll it next time, then it should be down, like here, the air pressure will be down and this should be up. Then it will, the lift will be reduced here and the weight, this will cause the lift and this will cause the weight. The weight and it will move like this. So next slide. So here you can see that the primary, secondary, and auxiliary controls are here. So primary are both like ailerons, like flaps and all are in secondary one, and in tertiary one are like in the flaps also some middle parts are here. Those who are responsible for controlling the aircraft surface. So here elevator, ailerons, and rudder as I discussed. Elevator is at the end and it's the horizontal one, and the ailerons are the on the wings. The main wings are there on the aircraft. There only here aileron will be there, and rudder will be like this. Like this is the elevator, and this one will be the rudder. The rudder will move like this to change the this yaw. It is known as yaw motion. So next slide. So elevator control system. In the elevator control system. For example, if we want to increase the lift, so the elevator will be move like this, then the air will move like this. Then as the air will reduce the pressure here, then the nose of the air will move like this. And as the pressure will increase, and this will move like this, and the tail will move like this, and this will cause the nose of the aircraft to push up. So it will move like this. So here we can see that elevators, the main elevators, like see here the elevator is. So the air pressure will be it move down and the nose will move up. And in the upper slide and upper one, you can see that the elevator is down. The elevator is down means that the air will push here and create a pressure. And this will create that it is just like inverted shutdown, like opposite and equal and opposite motion will be there, like this or like this. So the same you can see here the top movement and bottom view. Next. So here aileron, as I discussed that it's on the wings, the main wings of the aircraft, and ailerons will be mounted on the trailing edge. Like trailing edge, for example, this is the camber, and the trailing edge will be like you can see that trailing end one is like you can see like this. So one, this will be the main aileron. So here you can see that this is trailing edge and this is leading edge and this is the trailing edge. Trailing edge will be the end one. And like the aircraft, the air will move like this. Like from, for example, the air is coming here and it will move over the aileron and it will produce some like you can see that it swirls, or you can say it's like a whirlpool.
Swirls.
So, and here you can see the aileron, who is responsible. Like I already discussed that, like this, and one should be like this. One should be up and one should be down. For example, in the first case, you can see that left aileron down. Left, this is the left aileron in respect to me, and this is the right aileron. This is down and this is up. So, who is responsible? If the up one will create, the air will create pressure here, and it will move like this. And in the second one, the air will create pressure here. The air will move like this and it will move like this. So this is only responsible like rolling motion. So next is the rudder. The last control surface it's also it also plays the same game and another air is coming like this, like air is going here. So what happens is that it will make a yaw motion, like aircraft is like this. If the air is coming here, it will move like this. The aircraft will move like this. And if the it is like this, like it is move, it will move like this, and air will be like this. Like it moves like right or left. If it's right, the air will come from right side, and it will make the aircraft to yaw in right side. Right means right, and left means left. You can remember like this, but it's conceptual. Next is. So the Nadra cover is there. It's through the control of an aircraft. The system is there, like the numbering is given, like 2414, and all the numbering is just for the purpose of getting some inputs, the information, like how can like 2414, like 2% is located at the maximum camber. Maximum camber means the like it will be like the thick. And like 40%, like 0.4, like 40% means we can divide it by 100. So it will become like 0.4, and the leading edge. Leading edge is like this. This is the leading edge. So leading edge will be the maximum thickness. Maximum thickness means it will be like thick, so much thick. And the 12% will be the chord. The main chord is like the distance. The distance between the upper and lower. And the maximum thickness is at 30%. This is also divided by 100, so it will be the leading edge. Next slide. So here, the aircraft motion and control. Like we have seen all these things, like longitudinal and axis and latitudinal. So longitudinal is like this, and longitudinal is like this, and latitudinal is like this. So what happens is that in the longitudinal axis, the latitudinal force will be there. And in the longitudinal, the latitudinal force will act. So it's opposite always. Like you can see that in longitudinal, roll motion. Roll means like we are rolling like this. Here. And in pitch means like this or this. So and the vertical means like yaw. This is the yaw. And you can see that in the vertical one, yaw and rudder. Like yaw is like this is one is lateral and one is longitudinal. So it will be opposite always. So next is so here you can see that the roll motion will be like this, pitch will be like this, and yaw will be like this. So it will move like this. So these are the control surfaces. So we can see that there are three types of stability are there in the aircraft, like negative stability. Negative means earlier the aircraft was moving like this normally, but due to some holes and due to some disturbances, frictions and other forces, the unwanted forces, it moved like some disturbance will be there. So this will be negative. Like for earlier it was fine, it was normal only. So now it's disturbing. Next please. So positive one means like it was earlier it was creating some problem. Like earlier it was like this, but normally it is moving like straight. Here it's moving to the straight.